guys, I'm Kim and today I'm bringing you my TBR for the month of May. First of all, I decided to just show you the two books I'm currently reading. So books I started in April and I'm still continuing to read now that it is May. And the first one is The Barefoot Queen by Ildefonso Falcones. So this is actually the German edition, which is called Das Lied der Freiheit, but the English title is The Barefoot Queen. And I started this pretty much at the beginning of April, and I did have it on my April TBR, but I just had trouble getting into it, so it took me quite a while to read it, and now I'm not even halfway through, but it is getting interesting, so I'm hoping I'll finish it within the week. So that's one thing. The next one is The Wicked and the Divine, which is a graphic novel. I started this like 2 weeks ago, but I really, really like it. The only problem is I don't really read graphic novels a lot, so I mainly read on my Kindle when I'm out and about, and at home where I can actually read physical books, I'm just not really getting that much reading time in. And if I do, it's like before bed or something, and then I really just want to read. Then I just want to read, like, I don't know, reading a graphic novel isn't the same for me as reading a normal book. I don't know, I really like it and I really enjoy reading it, but it's not something that I just lay down an hour before bed and just read for an hour. It's just, I don't know. And then, as I said, I mainly read when I'm out and about, like on my commute and something, so it's just, I'm not getting that much reading time in for this, but I still really enjoy it. And I have no idea what this is about. I'm over halfway through, but I have no way to describe it. It's like, it's set in, I think, 2014, but just in general, like in now. And it's about those gods that are reborn every 90 years and they live for 2 years and then they die. And they're reborn in teenagers, so pretty much they're regular teenagers, and then one day they wake up and they're gods or something. And this time around, they decided to become superstars or rock stars or something. And yeah, I'm not really sure like what's going on or what's going to happen. Like, I don't really see a plot, but I still really, really enjoy it. So I'm really excited. And it is like part of a series. So this is the first book. So obviously it's not going to end with this book. So there's a lot more time for the story to develop. And I'm really excited about this. So for books that are on my TBR now, the first one I'm going to talk about is the only audiobook I have on my TBR, which I already started yesterday on May the 1st, and it is The Wise Man's Fear by Patrick Rothfuss. I already listened to the first one last month, and I'm really excited to get to this one. I read the first one 5 stars. I really, really loved it. I'm not exactly sure what to say about this book or how to describe it, because I don't really see where it is going yet, but it's so interesting and so exciting, and I really, really love the first book. But it's just, it's about this guy whose name is Quoth or something, and well, it's a high fantasy novel, so it's taking place in a fantasy world, and he owns this inn. He's an innkeeper, and then one day this scribe comes to his inn because he wants to write down Quoth's story. And so the main part of the book is Quoth's life story. And the first book ended when he was around 16 or 17, and it was really, really interesting. And it's always switching between the main story and the, like, the outer story. I know there is a word for it, I just can't remember it right now, where we are at the inn and Quoth is telling his story to the scribe. And the funny thing is, somehow, some way, during that story, which we do not know yet the full extent of, obviously, because it stopped when he was 16, and somehow later on he gets famous and like mythical or whatever. He's pretty much turning into a very infamous person. I don't know how to describe it, but people think he's died and they still admire him, and he's kind of turned into a superhero, something like this. And so in this inn where nobody knows who he really is, he has those regulars, And whenever they're there, they also like to tell each other stories. And most of those stories revolve around him. But obviously they don't know it's him. And it's so funny because sometimes there is his story being told, or he tells his story to the scribe. And then the next chapter is an interlude chapter where we see him and the scribe in his inn. And then we listen to those regulars telling the same story he just told, but the obviously not true and having been through 100 people story. You know how it is, like something happens and then the more people hear about it, the different is the story. And that's kind of what's happening here, and it's really, really interesting, and I'm really excited to get to the second book. But onto books I want to actually read, not listen to. The first two I actually had on my TBR for the month of April, but I didn't get around to reading them, so I'm planning on reading them now. First book is The Rose and the Dagger by Renée Adier. As I said, I already had this on my TBR for the month of April, and I did start it, but I just didn't get a lot of reading time into it. Again, it's not because of the book, but because of the same problems I said when it came to the graphic novel. I just mainly read on my commute, and then I read on my Kindle, so not on in the actual physical book. So I didn't really get far with this, and I'm really excited to get on with it because I love the first book, The Wrath and the Dawn, and so amazing. The second book I also had on my TBR, it's Traitor to the Throne by Alvin Hamilton, the second book in the Rebel of the Sands trilogy. And I really loved the first one, and I'm really excited to get on with the second one. Nothing more to say, except this, as The Rose and the Dagger, has kind of those oriental inspirations, or yeah, whatever. And I'm really excited about this. I kind of really like that kind of culture in books, and I'm really excited to read it. Hey, so my kitten is here, she demands attention, and she can be really, really demanding. So yeah, she probably wants food, although she does have food, but she just wants different food. So next book, let's get away from the cat. It's An Ember in the Ashes by Saba Tahir, which I'm also really excited to read. I don't really know what to say. I don't really know what this is about, because I want to go in not knowing too much about the books I read. So I said this one in my last TBR, and yeah, it's the same. I'm really excited for all those books this month. Last month my TBR wasn't that great. I put a lot of books down I thought I should read, or I thought sounded interesting, but I wasn't really that excited about them. And then during the whole month I was always feeling guilty because I didn't really read those books and just read other books. And now I just put a lot of books together that I really, really want to read, and I'm really excited about reading, and I'm really happy about that. The next one is The Star-Touched Queen by Roshani Chokshi. I hope I said it right. I probably didn't, so I'm really sorry. I didn't mean no offense. I just don't know how to pronounce it. Again, no idea what it's about. It's kind of taking place in an Oriental-inspired culture as well. Three of the other books I mentioned. Can you see a pattern? But I'm really excited about this one as well as about all the others. Then I have two more books. The first one is The Fall of Shannara, The Black Elf Stone by Terry Brooks. And here, I'm not exactly sure what to think about it, because I got this off of NetGalley, and I'm in the habit of checking Goodreads now before I request anything of NetGalley, because it happened to me a lot of time that it was second or third part in the series and it wasn't stated on the NetGalley page. So I requested a book, got it, and then was saying the third part in the series, which was really annoying. So for this book I checked, and it is the first part in the Fall of Shannara series. But as it turns out, there are about 37 other Shannara books. So yeah, what to do now? There are obviously recommended ways to read the series. Like, one is a chronological order, then there is one Terry Brooks recommended for people who reread the books and then there's one for how Terry Brooks recommends it for new readers. But obviously I'm not going to read 37 other books before I read this one, so we'll see how it turns out. The last book I want to read I also got off of NetGalley, and it's Breakwater by Catherine Jones Payne. This I hope is going to be kind of a break from all the other books, because all the other books I feel like are more like those epic fantasy kind of books, and this is also fantasy and high fantasy, but it's taking place in the ocean. I guess. It's about mermaids, so it's kind of something different. And yeah, I'm excited about this one as well. And that's pretty much it. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe, and leave me a comment. And that's it for today. Bye!